week, I started the Dragonborn DLC with my original character. It sent him on his first quest in over 10 years. And got a good way through the main quest of the Dragonborn DLC. And so we are in the... we have read the Black Book, and we're in this realm here. We got to figure out what Mirok knows and take him out. So I'm going to guess I got to wait for this thing. Let the journey continue. Yes, we are off. I feel like I'm going to need that. I've definitely enjoyed coming back to this game. I haven't done an actual, like, meaningful Skyrim playthrough in a very long time. The last time I even touched this game was probably 2 or 3 years ago. Oh, I see what's going on there. It was probably 2 or 3 years ago. I kind of messed around on the PC version with some mods and stuff, but I didn't really do anything meaningful in it. So it's been fun to actually get back into this game and actually play it. And it's been interesting to do it on the PS3 version. So it's been fun. I thoroughly enjoyed this stream last week. Okay, open chapter 2. I'm willing to bet that this is probably going to be at least a 3-part stream. I don't think I'm going to get done with everything that I want to get done today. So there will likely be one more piece to this story. Oh, we got a lurker over here. Okay. Huh? I'm at you. Oh, we got another one. Oh, we got a seeker. I'm at you. Oh, and another one. Take all of these. But anyway, considering that it's been a long time since I've done anything with this character, and this is likely going to be the last time I play this on a PS3, I wanted to send him off properly and not just like half-ass this. So if this takes me 3 streams, it takes me 3 streams. If it takes me 4 streams, it takes me 4 streams. I'm just kind of, I'm flying by the seat of my pants on this one. Okay, let's go to chapter 3. This is an interesting part of the quest and an interesting realm, for sure. Have at you. I still hear battle music. There's somebody else. There you are. I need to stop picking up every little thing because I'm almost maxed out on my carry weight. I don't understand what that did. Aw, damn it. Oh, that makes sense. I didn't realize I still had the Dragon Wren shout equipped. Alright, let's change that and go with the tried and true Fushro Da. Excuse you. Makes sense. Oh, I can't do anything about the tentacles I see. Well, let's continue on, I guess. Some funky ass looking dudes. Moving on to chapter 4. we got here?
Well done, my champion. Your journey towards enlightenment has finally led you here to my realm, as I knew it would. You have entered my realm. You have sought out the forbidden knowledge that only one other has obtained. You are dragonborn, like Mirak before you, a seeker of knowledge and power. Your power as dragonborn to bend the world to your will.
Not quite.
Here then is the knowledge you need, although you did not know you needed it.
Okay.
The second word of power. Use it to bend the wills of mortals to your purpose.
That sounds really neat, and I could definitely see how somebody with ill intentions would use that to their advantage.
Word of power. Without that, you cannot hope to surpass me. Mirak served me well, and he was rewarded. I can grant you the same power as he wields, but all knowledge has its price.
Okay. Yeah. If he's your ally, why help me defeat him? That's sus.
He has served me long and well, but he grows restless under my guidance. His desire to return to your world will spread my influence more widely, but it will also set him free from my direct control. It may be time to replace him with a more loyal servant. One who still appreciates.
Yeah, that's probably not going to be me, my guy.
The gifts that I have to offer. Even dragons submit to Mirak's voice. Without that power, you cannot face him. So say I, Hermaeus Mora, master of the tides of fate.
Okay. So what's your price?
Oh, no. The Skaar have withheld their secrets from me for many long years. The time has come for this knowledge to be added to my library. My servant Mirak would have found a way to bring me what I want. So will you, if you wish to surpass him.
Fair point.
send the Scar Seaman to me. He holds the secrets that will be mine.
Activate Dragonborn Flame. When your fire breath shout kills an enemy, a fireworm emerges from their corpse to fight for you for 60 seconds. You may only accept one ability from this book at a time. Oh, okay. Dragonborn Force. Your unrelenting force shout does more damage and may disintegrate enemies. And then frost encases foes in ice. Well, I use the unrelenting force quite often, so being able to just like disintegrate people sounds pretty lit. Not gonna lie about that. Now I think, help me out. What's his name? There was the one guy he's one of the dudes in the Civil War quest. I seem to remember he did that to somebody. You know, where he, like, disintegrated somebody using the Unrelenting Force or something like that. I seem to remember that being a thing. Getting one of the other ones, I feel like, would also be cool. The fireworm. Sounds pretty lit. Yeah, that's right. But also at the same time, encasing people in ice also sounds pretty lit. Let me see here. It was the Frost Breath Shout. So there's Fire Breath. I only know one of those, one of the Fire Breath. And two of the Frost Breath, but I know all three of the Unrelenting Force. So we'll do that one. It seems to make the most sense. That's good to know. I think I'm gonna go with the Unrelenting Force one because I use that one the most to begin with, and I already know all three words for it. So we'll do that.
Different people have very different experiences when reading these books. You're still acting surprisingly sane, too. What did he have to say? He must have wanted something from you.
It's none of your damn business. Well, I guess I'm gonna tell him anyways.
What secrets could they have worth keeping from old Mora? Sounds like a bargain to me. Hermaeus Mora learns some fascinating new ways to skin a hawker, and you become the second most powerful dragonborn that ever lived. Well, that gives me a lot to think about. I need to get back to Talmithrin. I have some ideas about how to locate more of these black books.
Well, you do that, guy. I got other shit to do. Oh, I forgot about the Stalrim armor and weapons. I think you get those through the companions, if I'm not mistaken. I think that's also where the werewolf thing comes from, and I'm pretty sure I did that with this character, but I also think I might have cured that because I seem to remember something about it got kind of annoying. Oh, and of course, there's a fucking dragon right here as soon as I come out. Where's Mirak to steal this dragon soul? I know it's coming.
What a waste of a good specimen.
Oh, cool. I actually got that one.
I have to get someone to bring this to me.
All right, you do that. All right, so now I got to go back and talk to them.
Be calm. I'm sure there's a good reason Baldur left us.
So the dragons have Hermaeus Mora. Old Hermamora himself. So he is the source of Mirak's power. Of course. We have many tales of trying to trick us into giving up our secrets to him.
What are your
and
secrets?
Now he comes again for what we have long kept from him. Ah. Ancient lore handed down from shaman to shaman since the Allmaker first gave Solstheim to the Skull. How to talk to the wind. How to listen to the earth. These are our secrets. Nothing of power or mastery. We know him as Hermamora, the demon of knowledge. It is in his nature to hoard secrets to himself. Their value to him is of no consequence. The very fact that the Skull have kept knowledge from him has merely increased his desire to have it. So it falls to me to be the one to give up the secrets to our ancient enemy. I do not know if I have the strength to face him. The Tree Stone is still corrupted. The land is still out of balance. But with the other five restored, it may be enough. It will have to be. Yes. The Skull also tell of the day when we must finally give up our secrets. When Hermamora finally wins.
Uh-oh.
As shaman, it is my duty to guard these secrets. But also to decide when it is necessary to give them up. I believe that time is now. If I am wrong, may my ancestors forgive me. Give me the book. I will read it and speak to old Hermamora myself. I will make sure he lives up to his part of the bargain. That is my hope as well. I am trusting that you will make this sacrifice worthwhile.
Yeah, those are wonderful options.
Father, you must not do this. That book is wrong, evil, against everything you have taught me my whole life.
I must, Freya. It is the only way to free Solstheim forever from Mirak's shadow.
Thanks for the tip about the screen tearing. Made a setting adjustment that looks like it's a little better.
Do not fear for me, granddaughter.
That looks pretty good now.
This is the destiny that the Allmaker has laid out for me.
I stand beside you, Father, as always.
I am ready for whatever the foul master of this book has in store for me.
Oh, damn.
Up their secrets to me. All your friends humming. Yeah, it's a good time coming. Everything you want, it's
right here, y'all. Everything you need, it's right here, y'all. Father! No, stop! Fire!
I won't. I won't. Not. For you.
Do something!
Dragonborn, you have delivered me the gift I requested. In return, I keep my promise as befits a Prince of Oblivion. I give you the word of power that you need to challenge Mirak.
So I happen
to... You will be either a worthy opponent or his successor, as the tides of fate decree.
So I happen to notice that my...
Father.
My desktop audio had something going on, and I had an advertisement playing on one of my internet browser tabs.
Destroy Mirak and lift his master's shadow from the land. Go then, kill Mirak. Do not fail.
I happened to notice one of the tabs open in my internet browser was like playing an advertisement, so hopefully the audio from the two didn't overlap each other for too long. So I muted that to take care of that problem, but, I'm not sure how long it was playing. Looks like maybe 3 seconds before I caught it. Yeah, that's probably what it was. There was a advertise, cause I've got the, like, Elder Scrolls Wiki up so I can kind of, you know, speed this along a little bit without,
We will miss you, but do not
you know, like with the houses and the Dragon Priest masks and stuff, and there was a like an advertisement video playing on one of those tabs. So I've just muted the desktop audio, so if any other ads decide to start playing,
we won't forget what you did for us, Storm Crackstrider.
That won't be an issue. Okay, so unlock my Bend Will shout. Bend Will Shout is unlocked. Read Waking Dreams. Where do I find Waking Dreams? I'm guessing I have to return to Apocrypha for that.
Send her back to us.
Oh, right there. Black Book, Waking Dreams. That's why I couldn't find it. Thank you. But yeah, when I'm playing through, like when I'm playing a console and running through a capture card, I run the audio from the console directly to my mixer, and then also my mic directly to my mixer. So if there's any sound playing on my desktop, I'm not gonna hear it. Whereas normally, I output my desktop audio directly to my mixer, so I can adjust my mic and, you know, PC audio through my mixer and then send it out. So that's how that happened. The whole music thing. How about you? I don't know why I randomly equipped a pickaxe, but there it is. Probably because it's the only one-handed weapon I have. I don't want to open. Dude, that would be lit. I don't want to open chapter 2, though. I guess we'll see where it takes me. We'll see what happens anyways. All right. That's trippy. I'm gonna wait for that to extend all the way out. Oh, there it is, right there. See, the thing is there's probably a bunch of them that I have done that I don't remember. So, like, I don't remember if I've done the Dark Brotherhood, so I wouldn't mind doing that one. there's also the, there was one time I started a mage playthrough, and I normally don't do mages. And there was one time, I started a mage playthrough and actually went through the entire College of Winterhold and actually had, like, a pretty decent mage. And that was actually more fun than I anticipated it being. And I wouldn't mind doing that again, actually, at some point. So I think if I ever do another, like, Skyrim playthrough, I might go the mage route. Because that ended up being more fun than I thought it was going to be. It's because a mage isn't my normal playstyle. You know, and actually maybe doing the main quest again would be kind of fun. Maybe that might be something I might add to the list at some point, is, like, another Skyrim playthrough, but I'll do it on PC and just mod the absolute death out of it. I'm pretty sure I've done the companions before, because I'm almost positive that's where the werewolf stuff comes from. And I'm almost positive I've done that one once. Like, I know for a fact that I've done, you know, I've been a werewolf, because there's, like, a ring that you get, and when you equip the ring, it turns you into a werewolf. Like, I think it's the ring itself that actually has the enchantment and everything. That does all that. Oh, what the hell? No clue where I'm going right now. Pretty sure this is the way I came in, yeah? Yeah. I'm very confused by this. And I feel like this shouldn't be this difficult to navigate. What did that open up, though? I didn't see it. Oh, right there. You know, I really wonder how much time it would take you to, like, read every book in here, because like I'd be interested to read, you know, this book here, the biography of Baron Zaya, because the, you know, the hell were they called? They were the unusual gems or something like that, are actually stones of Baron Zaya, and I think it's part of the Thieves Guild, which I know I've started the Thieves Guild, but I don't know if I've ever finished the Thieves Guild. Speaking of, you know, quest lines that I've never done. If I have done it, I'd like to do it again, because it's been so long. Bone mold shield of dwindling shock. All right. Where were you when the dragon broke? Oh, a lurker guardian. Well, lurker guardian. On guard. First blood drawn from the torso. Well, I think I won that. I forgot to mention at the beginning of the stream, kick back, relax, grab a drink, and share what I have to drink today. I picked up a pink lemonade from the gas station on the way home because it just sounded good. It's usually like part of my opening montage, you know. Kick back, relax, grab a drink, I got this, and then I get started, and I completely forgot. Does this matter? What the hell? Like, I'm assuming I gotta put something on every pedestal. I just wonder if the order matters. I guess there's only one way to find out, yeah? I'm gonna go with boneless limbs. And then... Life of Uriel Septim. Gotta have some reading material when he retires, right? Delving pincers. Oh, you dick. Confessions of a Dunmer Skooma Eater. That sounds good. Right? Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and guess that these have to be in a certain order because nothing happened. And I happen to notice on that last one, yeah, the pedestals have a different symbol on them, so I'm gonna go ahead and assume that the book is... related to the symbol. So, I'm going to say this one's boneless limbs. This one is delving pincers. This one is gnashing blades. And this one is prying orbs. Aha! I knew it. I know when I was playing this, when I messed around with some mods and stuff on PC, I started a playthrough as an Argonian who just like stole everything, and I didn't make it very far because I spent more time messing with mods than I did actually playing the game. But like, dude, I've seen some videos online and stuff where people have, you know, installed, you know, like a plethora of mods, and it looks almost like a whole new game. Oh, you chicken shit. Chicken shit.
Oh,
take that, Mr. the Man. I have to use the shout, but my shout was not charged. Oh, I have my own dragon priest? Lit. Riding a dragon, you can lock onto a nearby target and attack it with magic. You can also command the dragon to attack your target. Fast travel while riding the dragon by using your world map. For detailed information, see the help section in the main menu. Neat.
Beware. Mirak is strong. He knew. As you command. Move them quick.
Lit.
At once, Fufen are.
Yeah, riding a dragon's pretty lit.
As you command. At once.
Bye, guy. Yeah, it's too bad this guy's gonna retire here soon, because I'll have to do this all over again if I do another playthrough and actually want to use this.
Thank you.
I think I'm, like, dead. What the? All right. It was like the dragon was eating me, but also not at the same time. So hopefully this doesn't take me back too far. This fight's going to be interesting, I can tell. Has been interesting, I should say. Well, I've decided that simply because of that, I'm going to leave a negative But I'm going to leave a negative review on Steam for this. Because, even though this is the PS3 version, I'm leaving a negative review on Steam for it. Well, I think at the start of that Mirok fight, I'm going to do a manual save, just in case.
Thank you.
Alright, let's try this Murak fight again. This is probably another reason why I've got multiple save files for the same character, because I'd get to a spot like this and be like, okay, instead of having to redo all of this before it again, I will just make a save so I don't have to go back to the, you know, checkpoint spot. Shut up. Aw, damn it. Oh, do I have to fight him now? That kind of sucks.
Right.
Okay, I'm carrying too much. So, I don't need this Dwarven Dagger. You can have that. I don't need this Ebony War Axe. You can have that. You can have that. Hollowed Orcish Sword. Well, I can keep everything else for now. So, I probably should have left some of this stuff behind. So, this one, when health is low, has a chance to heal wear and damage nearby enemies. That's the one that I have now. And Mirak increases your magicka by 40 points. That's it? I'm going to keep this one. Mirak is down. Alright, so there's three more Dragon Priest masks as part of this DLC. Okay, that one's part of a quest. So I need to find White Ridge Barrow, which is here. It's right in this region, Mir. So it looks like the fastest way is going to be to fast travel to the Waterstone. This Dragon Priest mask isn't part of a quest, I don't think. But I think there is a quest that takes you here. It's Black Book, the Sallow Regent. Okay, so there is another black book apparently in here that you get in White Ridge Barrow. It says, within the Barrow is a word wall containing the word of the Cyclone Shout as well as the Dragon Priest Mask, Dukan. It is also the location of the black book, the Sallow Regent, and houses the Spider Scroll Imbuing Chamber. So, I'm just going for the Dragon Priest mask, but I'll grab the black book while I'm there. And then the other two Dragon Priest masks, I do believe are, I have to complete quests for those. Well, that's not going to take me there. You haven't truly played Skyrim if you're not trying to scale a 90-degree cliff face. Not some Nurn root. The house that I think I want to get for this guy, I looked at the quest requirements, and do you remember the quest where it's when you walk into Dawnguard and everybody's having nightmares, and that whole quest? You have to complete that quest first, and then afterwards the Jarl will give you another quest, which is just killing a giant at a random giant camp. And once you complete those two things, you'll get the deed for... you can buy the deed for the land. And I've got the dragon, or not the dragon, the giant quest currently uncompleted in my quest log. So that shouldn't take me very long, and then I can get that house. So that'll be cool. A flaming spider. Bro, normally you want to kill spiders with fire, but you can't kill it with fire if it's already on fire. I'm not... Okay, I guess I am in combat. Might as well mine a ruby geode while I'm here. Oh, that's neat. To be honest with you, though, I'm probably not going to take the time to do that. Dragonborn here's got shit to do. A mind control spider. That sounds pretty lit, actually. Wow, that's cool. Thank you. Heartstone. Man, might as well get it while I'm here. I don't know what Heartstone's used for, but I'll grab it while I'm here anyways. Well, that's not what I was intending to do. What you know about them Wendy's Frosties on 45 degree angle bricks? Oh, is this dude chucking spiders at me? Oh, you just chuck spiders at him. Neat. Gotcha. I think that's the way I came in, yeah? Oh, I see. So this must be where you make the spiders, yeah? I'm guessing you get the spider pods and then... spider experiment notes. Oh, Ruby plus a pod. Oh, okay. Well, that's kind of neat. Well, I'm not gonna worry about it, but it's still kind of cool. Oh, a potion sent me over the edge. I don't really need that. There's a lot of things I'm carrying that I probably don't need. Like, I don't really need all this dragon bone and dragon scales. Or the flagon in my inventory. I'm gonna have to drop some more shit in order to carry these other dragon priest masks, I know that. That's all that was over here? Oh, okay. This must be our dragon priest. There he is. Increases frost resistance by 50% and frost spell damage by 25%. All right. Arrows don't take up any weight. I don't really need this sword, so I guess you can have that. I don't remember what this is. I think that was one of the dragon priest weapons. you know what? I guess I can just... Because these dragon bones weigh 15 pounds a piece. And the dragon scale's 10 pounds a piece. So that, yeah, that freed up 170 pounds worth. I got a Thuum Master. Here's the black book. I didn't really want to go back to that realm, but okay. Learn the Black Book's hidden knowledge. Yeah, I don't really want to do that right now. So, it was the... Oops. I have a lot of books I could probably get rid of, too. There we go. So I'm guessing I just fast travel out of here now. So where's my next Dragon Priest mask going to be? He can be encountered in the Nordic ruin of Kolbjorn Barrow at the conclusion of the quest Unearthed. Given to the Dragonborn by Rallus Sedaris. He tells the Dragonborn that he has an investor who wants relics of Azadal, but they are buried deep within Kolbjorn Barrow. Multiple investments and many days will be required in order for Kolbjorn Barrow to be excavated. I have to fund the excavation. This looks like a little bit of a longer quest, but I kind of want the extra Dragon Priest masks. All right, so where do I find this guy? He can be found outside the Barrow and needs funding for the excavation. This kind of sounds like a pain in the ass. It says, after some time, a courier will deliver a letter asking for your assistance once more. Throughout the mission, he will ask for more gold in order to hire more miners initially and subsequently mercenaries. The second time, he requests 2,000, the third, 3,000, and finally 5,000. So this quest costs $11,000. Before he's finally done with the work needed to complete the mission. He's essential to the quest and can be killed or spared at the end of the aforementioned quest. If he survives the events, he will move to the Retching Nets in Raven Rock and can be recruited as a follower. He can be considered the most expensive follower in the game and the only one who calls the Dragonborn boss. So, here's the thing. I was going to get all of the Dragon Priest masks, right? That was my plan. However, I have to pay this fucking guy 11,000 coin, and I've got 22,000. So that's gonna, you know, have the amount of coin that I have. I wonder if I can get it back from him. And it sounds like this quest takes a while, because it says fund the excavation, wait for a message. And then after going a little while, it says fund the next phase, wait for a message. Fund the next phase after doing a bunch of shit, wait for a message. Do a bunch of shit, fund the next phase, which is another 5,000, wait for a message. So this quest is meant to be taken over some time. I probably should have done that as soon as I showed up, and I could have, like, maybe done bits and pieces here and there in between other quests. And then this is the final descent. So this one is just speak to a guy, retrieve a journal, read it, escape, and return to the guy that gave you the quest. I don't want to just leave these last two Dragon Priest masks, but I really don't want to go through all the shit. Maybe? Let me see here. Okay. Well, I guess let me go talk to... that's 11,000 fucking coin, though. That's a lot of coin. I do have a lot of shit that I can sell. So, I mean, there is that. But that's a lot of coin. Okay, so where is this guy? He's outside... the place I need to go. So that is looks like this region right in here. So I should be able to just... oh, I cannot fast travel from this location. Well, that's dumb. I wonder if I can fast travel from inside here. Well, the one, like, positive of long PS3 load times is I've got time to take a drink. Thank you. Here, have a drink. Might as well sleep and get that well-rested perk. It's because Billy is the extreme. Man, I need to watch that movie again. Okay. Fast travel. Hawala fa kara ba rahi kalu puja kanfaru ki ja gura gura gura. I was just reading the loading screen. It's a special song. Yeah, it is.
Yes, sit with me. What's the matter with you? Sorry, I've just had a lot of pork-faced cowards coming by to mock my efforts. It probably can't hurt to tell you. You look mostly honest. The name's Rallus. Rallus Sedaris, out of Morhold. I've got a financier waiting for me back on the mainland. Sent. But this whole thing became a disaster. You come out of the Northern Ashlands, you don't expect things to go easy. When I first got to Kolbjorn, you couldn't even see it. Dug out a pile of the stuff taller than me just to find the barrel. Excavating isn't exactly my specialty. You think I've got that kind of money? No. Takes money to make money, all that rot. There's a lot of it at the other end. But I can't get there without... What? Are you... We can sort out the details, Father Moraine. Do you have the gold?
Yeah, I guess.
It's all... I'll head back to Raven Rock and round up some... Pleasure doing business with you, partner.
Alright, well, now that I got that one going... let's see. The other one that I need is this one. And it's the Final Descent quest, which is given to me by this guy in Raven Rock. So I need to go to Raven Rock, which I was just at, and find this guy. Cresius Corellius. So I'll go do this one while I wait on Homeboy to do what he's going to do. And then that maybe we'll speed that up a little bit. I might be able to just wait, like you said, and just wait for him to get word back to me. But I'll do this one. I just got to find the guy. He can usually be found in Raven Rock Mine.
Miserable. Just miserable.
I work for Moat.
Woman, I said to leave me be. Who in the blazes are you? Can't you see I'm busy? Why should I tell you? I don't even know who you are. Maybe. Been difficult trusting people lately. They think I'm crazy. But mark my words, these mines hold a secret that could put Raven Rock back. A secret the East Empire Company swept under the rug 2 centuries ago. It killed my great-grandfather and left Raven Rock with a worthless and tainted mine. Gratian Kyrellius. He spent his entire life exploring ancient ruins across Tamriel. And he died in these very mines almost 200 years ago.
So what you're saying is it's all because you're no good... Dirty, you're no good, dirty, rotten, mining great-great-grandfather? Or the East Empire Company. He doesn't sound like he was no good, dirty, rotten. It was the no good, dirty, rotten East Empire Company.
My wife and I were cleaning out our home. I found an unsent letter he'd written to the East Empire Company and a key. It describes a discovery that was made in the mine. The East Empire Company must have felt it was of great value as they locked that section of the mine off. It is. Well, I assume it is. I haven't been able to find the end. Now you're starting to sound... I'm telling you, there's something big down there.
All right, so...
Look, my wife nags that I'm... Time's my enemy. It's caught up with me.
So just give me
the
key.
...that I'm looking for. I do. I want to know what happened to Gratian, and what the East Empire Company is keeping from all of us.
Well, I think there's like 3 quests you get from this guy, and I think the Dragon Priest...
Find his remains. I'm hoping it will help. Here's everything I have.
I'm pretty sure the Dragon Priest is in like the first quest, and I think there's a weapon that you get from him that's...
That I've lost.
In another quest he gives you. Howdy, Cold Mountain 97.
Be careful down there. It can be treacherous.
So, if I get the Dragon Priest mask, I'm probably not going to do anything else for this guy.
Yeah.
really all I'm interested in is that Dragon Priest mask. No, not 100% completion. 10 years ago, I started this save file, likely around the time Skyrim first came out, back in 2011. And then after a while, I had like started other characters, you know, other save files and stuff like that, and I kind of just left this dude just standing outside of a shop in Whiterun. And then all of a sudden 10 years went by and I never got back to it. So basically what I'm doing is I'm doing a couple more quests with this guy, wrapping up a couple of things, and then I'm going to like build him a house, you know, find him a, you know, maybe a life partner, and then, you know, actually set him down, you know, like in a nice chair or something like that, and then leave him be. So just kind of like finish up what I was intending on doing with this character, so to speak. And one of the things I had done with this character was collected all of the Dragon Priest masks. And there was 4 more Dragon Priest masks introduced in the Dragonborn DLC, so I'm getting those. So I have every Dragon Priest mask, including the DLC Dragon Priest masks. And then, like, this playthrough, I had, like, stopped playing before the DLCs even came out. So I wasn't able to, like, build a house or anything like that. So I'm gonna build a house and, you know, all that kind of stuff, and basically settle the guy down, put his weapons and armor away, and actually give this guy a proper ending. Because I just left him sitting outside of a shop in Whiterun for over 10 years. And considering that I also have this game on PS4 and PC... it's likely I'm never going to play the PS3 version after this ever again. I'm kind of surprised I even still had the PS3 version in my game box. Yeah, initially I've been playing through the Metal Gear series and doing some other things, but this is one thing I wanted to get through. Before I moved on with the Metal Gear series, because I picked up the Master Collection when that came out. And I was going to go through all the games on that. And decided to take a break from that for a little bit and kind of fit this Skyrim thing in here. One of the things I did when I first loaded this save up, I went to Riften and talked to the one chick down in the Ragged Flagon and changed his appearance and made him look a lot older and everything. You know, I suppose standing in one spot for 10 years would make you a little older. cool. Take that, Mr. the Man. You know, that was one thing I did a lot in Oblivion that I never really got into with Skyrim was the enchanting tables. I remember, like, enchanting everything in Oblivion, and I just never really got into that in Skyrim. Like, I remember enchanting every piece of armor, every weapon. If I could put an enchantment on it, I did. Oh, is this... Nope, that's not the black book. I think there's a black book down here, too. I don't know, I just... Yeah, I guess I never felt the need to in this game, or... I feel like more of it was just that, like, I was constantly upgrading my armor and weapons and didn't want to, you know, spend the time and effort to enchant everything when I could just, when I was going to upgrade the shit anyways to, you know, a better weapon or, better armor. Something like that, so it just kind of felt like a waste. So by the time I got, like, the dragonbone armor and everything, it was like I had kind of already moved on from this character, so I just never really felt like I had the final suit of armor that I was going to get and everything. So what the hell was the purpose of that? Oh, shit. Ooh. That's a pretty neat looking, sword. I had seen that the guy, like, gives you more quests and stuff like that, so I just kind of assumed that the weapon would be part of a different quest, but, yeah, I'll take that. And optionally, I can read his journal, so let's go ahead and do that. Received a letter from the East Empire Company today. They say that some of the miners broke through the wall in Shaft 3 of Raven Rock Mine and found some ruins. I hope this isn't another waste of time like that fiasco they sent me to in Cyrodiil. I'll gather my assistant Milius and sail back to Raven Rock at first light. It'll be nice to see the old house in Solstein again. Finally arrived at Raven Rock and was surprised that a number of Dark Elf refugees living in the town. They aren't really from mining stock, but I think they'll make fine workers one day. Milius and I spent a good part of the day clearing the ash off of the roof of my house. The damn volcano was still erupting almost day and night. If it wasn't for the ash covering everything, it would almost look beautiful. Milius and I are headed to Raven Rock Mine to have a look at whatever it is the miners uncovered. I think I'll stop by the old swing and scoop and pick up a few supplies before we head down. Couldn't hurt to be prepared. Looks like the miners broke right through the wall of an old Nordic burrow. I've seen this sort of thing in Skyrim before. Damn Nords have burrows dotting the landscape, and almost none of them are ever marked on any maps. Looks like this burrow belonged to something called the Blood Skull Clan. I'm going to take some rubbings of these inscriptions on the tombs and see if I can't learn some more information from my history books. It's been a few days, and I can't find even a single mention of this clan anywhere. Milius and I decided to proceed ahead. We've come to a drop-down point, but I can see a massive chamber below. Took the better part of a day to lower everything down and climb down the almost sheer drop. It's been an astonishing day of discovery. After exploring the large chamber beyond the drop-off, I was startled to find the strangest weapon I've ever laid eyes upon sitting on a pedestal of sorts. The blade appears to be flawless and is emitting a faint, chilling glow. Bits of parchment I found in the chamber seem to call this the Blood Skull Blade. Not certain if I should remove it yet. I think I'll sleep on it. I've decided against my own better judgment to remove the Blood Skull Blade from its pedestal. Milius seems completely against it, but we need to bring this wondrous artifact with us when we find a way out of the burrow. I should have listened to Milius. The moment the blade was lifted, we were set upon by Draugr. Milius fought bravely, but he fell. I was able to destroy the remaining ones, but I was badly wounded. I can barely stand. My only chance would be finding a way out of this place, but I fear that I'm trapped. Exploring has been slow. I can only move for maybe a few minutes at a time before I have to rest. My supplies are running low, and I'm feeling weaker by the hour. The only progress I've made is finding a strange door with markings on it that I've never seen. There appears to be something to them I'm missing, as they've confounded my attempts at getting through. I'll have to study this further in order to make any progress. Barely can keep awake. I'm fairly certain that the key to the door involves the use of the Blood Skull Blade. When swinging the weapon, I'm noticing a ribbon of mystical energy emanating from it. I think by swinging the sword in different directions, it's possible to manipulate this ribbon and solve whatever puzzle this door presents. I hope to get well enough to put this to the test tune. Each swing is a huge effort. I've lost track of time and my strength is fading. I can't even stand anymore. My wounds refuse to heal. I'm afraid this tomb will become my resting place. If anyone finds this journal, please send these notes to my superiors at the East Empire Company and tell my wife that I love her. May RK guide me to my final rest. Okay, I'm glad I read that. Because now I need to equip that, apparently. Still don't quite understand. No. What it is I'm supposed to do here. To open the door, equip the Blood Skull Blade. When doing a power attack, a red beam will come out of the blade. If doing a horizontal attack done by moving side to side while doing a power attack from a standing position, a horizontal beam will come out. Done by moving to the side when doing a power attack. Oh, there we go. Yeah, that's pretty lit. I'm glad I got it. That big ass chest. For 2 gold. I didn't make a save before this either. This is going to be a good time. I don't have many health potions either. Well, I wonder if that Blood Skull Blade, if that power attack would, like, knock him back. You know, stagger him a little bit. Keep him from shocking my ass. Because that's going to be brutal. Yeah. Well, this might work. Providing I can stay alive long enough. Got him. Increases shock resistance by 50%, shock spell damage by 25%.
I am invincible!
That's right. Alright, so there's that. I love how this big chest is sitting here, and it only had 2 gold in it. I should leave a negative review on Steam for that. So is there, like, no exit from here? It's like there's always an exit at the end of these, so you don't have to go all the way back through the damn thing, right? Okay, well, there's the black book, enchanting table. Anciently ancient trophies, yes. Damn it, I was hoping I could just take it and not have to go through this. Alright. So I only need the one Dragon Priest mask. And then I'm done with Dragon Priest masks. So what I would like to do is get that mask and then head back to Skyrim, kill the giant, and at least purchase my plot of land. I'd like to at least get that far tonight. It is already, like, 2 a.m, though. Climb the stairs, bro.
time to die! I knew it! Filthy hemlock!
Yes! Fucking awesome. Bone mold armor, that's what that is. I was like, what kind of fucking armor is that shit? I can adopt up to 2 children. Should I give him children? That's the thing, because you can't have your own. You can only adopt them. But like, should this guy adopt children, or just, you know, find himself a honey to settle down with? I haven't decided on that yet. I mean, it would add more things to do, because I'd still have to go get the Amulet of Mara, find him a partner after building a house and everything. So it's like, I've already got, you know, quite a bit still left to do here. So I feel like that might just add even more time to what I'm trying to do here. Just yeeted. Of course, there's still somebody left. He's probably way up there. So I'm not going to be able to fast travel until I deal with him. Yep, there he is. There we go. Alright, so that... Okay. I feel like I at least need to go back and tell this and give this dude his journal and everything. Like, dude's kind of put his life into that. I suppose what I could do today, like if it seems like this one quest is going to take me a long time, right? If this is going to take me a while, I could probably travel back to Skyrim, kill the giant, purchase my land, and then, come back here for this, you know, last Dragon Priest mask. I could potentially do that, at least get the plot of land. I probably should have waited till it was like a certain hour or something, because technically I just broke into the guy's house.
You're not supposed to be in here.
My bad. That's all me. My bad.
Hmm.
You've committed crimes against the Dunmer people of Solstheim. What say you in your defense?
Here.
Wise choice. Now come along with us. After we confiscate any stolen goods, you'll be free to go. After you pay the fine, of course.
Squatting isn't tolerated in the abandoned house. If you need...
Yep. Okay, I guess I'll wait 8 hours outside your house. Now watch, he's not even going to be in his house. He's going to be, like, back in Raven Rock Mine. How am I supposed to talk to the guy? Yeah, it's very possible that this could end up being four parts. I was kind of expecting to be done with these Dragon Priest masks a little faster than I thought they were going to take. So, yeah, it might end up being a four-parter. Hopefully I get to keep the weapon, though. Hopefully he doesn't want it back.
You're back. Please, tell me what you found. Let me see that. Huh, I knew it. Gratian's... Now that I have his journal in hand, I can get some close... Thank you.
Good luck with that.
Now, I believe I owe you a little more than a debt of gratitude for all that work you did. Here, it's not much. But it's the best an old retired miner can do.
600 gold? All right.
Mark my words. Raven Rock.
All right, well, let me head over and... Well, I still haven't gotten the message from the dude yet. So I wonder if that would maybe speed that up a little bit, like travel to Skyrim, buy my land, work on my house. Oh, hey, guy. You know, I got some more people. Okay, here's some more money. You know, and kind of just jump back and forth between the two for a little bit, but I kind of didn't want to do that either. Ooh. Well, I guess let us wait 24 hours and see what happens. Okay, so according to what I just read here, It says you have to be in an entirely different place, says Raven Rock is far enough away, for 3 days. So if I fast travel to Raven Rock and wait 3 days, that should be enough to speed this along. So that's a thing. So basically, I wait 3 days, I wait for his message, I give him more money, I go back to Raven Rock, wait 3 days, go give him his money, and kind of rinse and repeat, I guess. Yeah, because once I leave here, I'd like to just be done with this whole area, and then go work on my house. It would be kind of funny to go from playing this on a PS3 and then downloading a boatload of mods. And,
why you'd leave your homeland behind?
You know, download a boatload of mods and then play a bunch of it again. Well, I even think when they did the Skyrim Special Edition, which was like the version they released on PS4 and PC, years later, Special Edition, I think, had like some updated textures and graphics and stuff when they released that version. So just going from a PS3 to a PS4 theoretically should look better as well. Okay, I've done waited like 3 days over here. Like, I'm assuming somebody's just gonna run up to me at some point and be like, hey, here's a message from the guy. I guess we just keep waiting till somebody shows up. Here's one that says, it says, head back to Raven Rock, wait 24 hours, now return to Kilburn Barrow. The Barrow will now have a small camp set up. You'll see the miners working on the site. Once again, return to Raven Rock, then wait for 2 days. You'll get a message from them. Wait 2 days, fast travel somewhere, then return to Raven Rock. And a courier will have a delivery for you.
We've got a crew on it. They're not sharp, but they're working hard.
About time.
Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see here. Got this from a pretty excited looking dark elf around Raven Rock. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Hopefully I can at least, like, find some shit down in here that'll give me some of my money back. I'm not overly excited about giving this guy 11 grand when I kind of need some money to build a house.
Blink, all the miners were dead. This is what I get. Well, unless you want to deal with... Might be over either way. It looked like a dead end before the place started crawling. We could have missed something. I don't know.
Of course, now I gotta actually do work for the fucking guy. I'm getting too old for this shit. I can see why homeboy would want to retire after all this. Like, man, I'm just going to build myself a house and retire because none of y'all can do shit for yourselves. So it's looking like it's going to be highly possible that I don't get this quest done tonight either. Unless I, you know, start getting into, like, marathon territory. Now I gotta find a way deeper in, huh? Boots of water walking. All right. Neat. I might actually fast travel back to Skyrim and maybe get rid of some of the shit in my inventory. I guess it depends on how much room I have. Because after dropping a bunch of that, like all the dragon bone and stuff, I got quite a bit more. So I should be able to pick out everything I want from here on out.
To sweeten the pot a bit this time. I think I never get tired of this.
Okay.
Take me a few days.
So now it says head back to Ravenrock for and wait a day, then travel back to the Barrow, and then return to Ravenrock and wait 2 days. And then it says this can take a few attempts because of how things work out. And then, once I return, I gotta clear more Draugr from it, find missing miners, fund the next phase, wait for another message, clear the Draugr again, fund the next phase, wait for a message, return again, then defeat the Dragon Priest. So I gotta wait, let's see, this time, 2, 3, including this time, I have to wait 3 more times. Like, I don't think this is gonna happen today. Unfortunately. It's already after 2 a.m. and I am getting a little bit tired. Hence why I haven't been yapping my beak as much during like these load times and stuff. So, I don't know. I think what I'll do is I'll maybe wait this out, and get get through the next phase of the excavation. That would put me about halfway through this quest. And then from that point, maybe I'll call it a night. And then next week, I'll finish this up. And then work on the house. So, considering I didn't think this was going to take this long, I was kind of expecting this retirement to be a three-part angle. Or a three-part series. This is likely going to drag it out into a fourth. Because I don't think I'm going to have this entire house built in one stream. It might not be as bad as I thought. That might go by quicker than I remember, but I seem to remember getting all the materials and everything that you need for all that. It was a fairly lengthy process. I guess we'll just have to see what happens. Again, I since this is the last time I'm going to play as this character, not today. This particular session ain't going to be the last time, but this particular series, this particular, you know, quest line and everything that I have planned for this guy is the last thing I'm going to do with him. You know, and then because I've never done this. I've never like sat down with an RPG style game and went, you know, this is the last time I'm going to play this. So I'm going to like write an ending to the story. Usually it's always been, you know what, I'll get back to this at some other time. I'm going to play this instead and then never get back to it. You know what I mean? I don't think I've ever retired a character in an RPG game in my life. So I for some reason, I just really want to do this in a way that's fitting, in a way that's not just, you know, I loaded it up, made him a house, and then turned it off. You know, it's like I got to do something with the guy still, you know, give him that proper send off. So, yeah, we're going to spend some time with the guy before we let him go. I mean, and I did enjoy the hell out of last week's stream. This one's been a lot. This one kind of grinded up to a much slower pace this week. Last week, I moved through, you know, quite a bit of the Dragonborn DLC fairly quick. You know, plus last week there was also the, you know, the initial, you know, load of the save. There was the, you know, the rediscovery and all that kind of stuff. You know, was a big part of it. That was cool to see. So this one was kind of just jumping back into where I was already at, you know. So part one, I feel like was a more enjoyable experience for both myself and anybody that might be watching this. I feel like part one was a little more enjoyable. This one, it's a little bit slower paced. And then the next one will probably be about the same as well, because it's probably going to be a lot of house building and waiting for this fucking guy to dig shit. Dig it out, dig it. Dig it out, dig it. Hey, man, maybe you should just eat the dirt. That might make things go a little faster. I feel like I should just walk up to that guy and just be like, "My name is Mr. Sir, and you will call me by my name. Is that clear?" Yeah, I definitely should. I wish I would have, like, I guess looked at the quests ahead of time, and realized that this was such a, you know, long drawn out process. I could have went and talked to this guy as soon as I showed up here, then like did the main quest, you know, or bits and pieces of the main quest, and then, you know, like had this one advancing in the background while I was doing all of the other shit. So by the time I was done with all of that, maybe this dude would have been done too. But, you know, you don't know what you don't know, I guess.
I've been looking.
Yeah, yeah. Shut up.
Another note from your friend Rallus. Looks like that's it. Got to go.
So let's see. Now I have to clear the Draugr again and search for the missing miners. Then speak to him again, then fund the next phase, then wait again. Then clear the Draugr again, speak to him again, then fund it again. So I've got two more waiting periods after this one. Part of me wants to just hammer it out and be done with it. But then at the same time, I also am getting kind of sick of waiting, but I also don't want to start the next stream just waiting. So, eh. kind of not sure how to do this one here. What is it this time?
Draugr again. I mean, we should have expected it. At least six of the diggers are. You've had some luck with these things before. Do you think you're going
getting sick of this shit, man?
Go back in. See if anyone's still alive.
That is true. A little bit of waiting and then a dragon priest fight. Yeah. That could work. I mean, I did still accomplish a decent amount. I beat Mirak, and then got two more of the Dragon Priest Mask. So I got three of the four in one go round. It's not too bad. Night. Lit. I think that's the first time I've seen somebody get disintegrated. What the hell? That was dumb. Yes. Oh shit, I just blew her body into the door. Can I get a nubs? Ah, sorry.
What'd you do?
That's on me. My bad. Let's see. Search for the missing miners. Fund the next phase. Wait. Fund the next phase. Wait. So I'm going to have to do two more wait sessions. I'm approaching the 3-hour mark. So I'm gonna call it a night as soon as I talk to this guy. I'll have two wait sessions next week and then a Dragon Priest fight. And then hopefully I can get things moving a little bit on the house. He's getting ready to retire. I can say that.
Any new?
I should have figured. Well, at least we can get back to work. But how? I'm going to hire some mercenaries. Well, it'll set the miners at ease. It's going to hit 3,000 this time, I'm afraid. We're going to be making this back 50-fold.
We better be.
I'll go hire a new crew and some brawny time.
So now I'm down to 18,000 coin.
Come back and check in. Nothing can stop us this time.
All right. Well, let's head back to Raven Rock, and that's where we're going to call it a day. So if you've been watching this whole thing on this whole 3-hour video on YouTube, just know I greatly appreciate it. The subscribe button will be right up there. That direction over there will be a playlist for this whole little series. And do check out some of my other videos. I've got, you know, speed runs and a lot of other casual playthroughs and, you know, a lot of good stuff on there. So the majority of it, the good majority of it is live stream replays. And the good majority of it is the rest of it is either speed runs or live stream replays is pretty much all I really have on my YouTube. But you know, if you happen to find any of that stuff and you like what you see over there, then bring yourself over to Twitch and, you know, hang out with us in real time. But until then, stay suave, and, I'll see y'all on the next video next week, at least for this series. So stay suave.